I recently tried beard oil, John.
I'm Did it smelling. Give you better gas mileage?
Yeah, it really helped my engine. It was like baby oil. I put it on my bottom, and now I'm so smooth. No, the problem with beard oil is...
Incidentally, you are hairy down there, I heard.
You can just smell it. Like, it's on your mustache, so...
What
it's
kind
right
of,
there.
It's got to be a plant oil or a mineral. What is it?
Yeah, it's like a, some sort of a woody scented oil, I guess. It's all plant based.
Let me get this straight. You have a woody like, under your nose?
Mm-hmm, yeah, it's plant based, just like my beard. This is actually moss. It's just growing. It's some sort of lichen attached to my
you're
face.
You're a chia pet? You're telling me you're a chia pet.
Always have been. I just go and mow it. I hate seed day when I have to wipe that seedy goo on my face.
Oh, seed day.
What do we got?
Dave. Hello, fellow humans. Hope you're enjoying the Halloween special. It's been weird. It's been a fun week.
It's been a journey.
It's been a journey. Dave. What song do we have? I'll tell you what we have, Dave. We have a song you've probably heard a version of before.
Okay.
And you probably thought it was the original version.
All right.
But it weren't.
What version do you think I've heard of this song?
Oh, I know you've heard Santana do this song. I know you have. It's okay. A ubiquitous song. I know you've heard Santana do the song. Maybe you haven't, but I know you have. Anyway.
Maybe you haven't, but I know you have.
But what can you tell me about Fleetwood Mac?
Give me everything
you know about Fleetwood Mac. Name a song. Give me some stories. Give me something on Fleetwood Mac.
Didn't we do a Fleetwood Mac song?
I'm certain we have. Would you like me to research that?
It's not coming into my brain.
I hate when that happens.
Well, it happens.
Come on, name something, Fleetwood Mac. You can do this.
Look, I believe that I'm on record thinking Fleetwood Mac was a country band. So
exactly, which ought to remind you that we've done Fleetwood Mac before. Yeah,
that is, so I guarantee we've done Fleetwood Mac. Did they do the song that was about power lines?
Power lines?
Yeah, it was, or telegraph lines.
No, that's Dire Straits.
See,
Telegraph
it's
Road. You're
Dire Straits, the other country band.
You know what? They're a lot more country than Fleetwood Mac is, I'll tell you that. Let me see what Fleetwood Mac we've done, because I know we've done some Fleetwood Mac. I am searching. F-L-E-E-T Wood.
Fleetwood.
We have done, Secondhand News. That's the only one we've done.
Yep. I do remember that.
Okay. So other than that, can you name any Fleetwood Mac? Really?
Mm-mm.
Dave?
I'm sure that if you played some, I'd probably be like, oh, okay, I've heard the song before, but I couldn't just name it.
Well, you're ruining my object lesson here, but anyway, this is Fleetwood Mac before the Fleetwood Mac of Secondhand News.
Oh, good. That changes everything for me.
Just pretend it does. Look, we're trying to win an Emmy here. Or something.
I don't think you can get an Emmy for YouTube.
I don't know. Dude, what do you win for YouTube? You win the little YouTube plaque on the wall?
There you go. YouTube plaque.
Okay. We're looking for a YouTube plaque here, Dave. Act it up a little bit, please. Help me out here.
Oh, my. Pre-news.
Just stop. Never mind. What I just said. Cancel that. So most people associate Fleetwood Mac with You Make Lovin' Fun and Secondhand News.
At least I've heard
and,
that one.
And the one the Clintons used on their on Bill Clinton's first campaign trail.
I was like 7 when that happened.
And you weren't listening to pop music.
And not allowed to listen to pop music.
Anyway, Fleetwood Mac is known for Stevie Nicks, Lindsey Buckingham. But Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham joined Fleetwood Mac to become basically a whole brand new band and change the musical direction and style. The band. They started out, Dave, as a British-based American blues band.
Hmm.
And they penned this song, which fits in with our Halloween holiday theme, called Black Magic Woman. Got a black magic woman. You ever heard that before?
I don't know. I'll let you know once I start listening to the song.
You won't recognize this version because everybody thinks Santana did the original. This is the original, and it's a good, cool blues tune.
All right, here we go.
Got a
black magic woman. Got a black magic woman.
Yes, it is bluesy.
Got
a black magic woman. Got me so blind I can't see. That she's a black magic woman and she's trying to make the devil out of me. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Yes, don't turn your back on me, baby. Don't mess around with your tricks. Don't turn your back on me, baby, because you might just break up my magic. Oh, that's uncomfortable. That was a short song.
Well, you know, it was the 60s.
Fair enough. Okay. That was not what I expected. I mean, a little bit, I guess, because you prepped me that it's going to be bluesy.
So
I totally get that. I don't think I have ever heard that song.
Really?
No, it didn't sound familiar at all.
Okay, we're going to edit this out so we don't have to write long, detailed legal letters to two different companies that own rights to songs. But I'm going to bring you the video, Dave, and you just keep rolling or pause your choice. And, we're going to play for you in the background, the Santana Black Magic Woman.
Nope. Never heard it.
Really? Gosh, it shocks me how sheltered you lived.
Yep. That seems right. After all the stories I've told you, I'm kind of surprised that you're still shocked by how sheltered I was.
I know, but that song is I'm telling you, that's ubiquitous.
Nope. It was all brand new to me.
Next time you talk to your mom, say, do you know some Black Magic Woman? Who's it by? And see what she says. Anyway, because I know she was a rocker in her youth, and she turned to the Lord later.
Well, so, I only know one version of her, so.
Yeah, I understand. That was the Peter Green led version. He was the songwriter of that song. Peter Green was the founder of Fleetwood Mac, but Peter Green is one of those guys that doesn't want to be in the front.
Okay. There's nothing wrong with that.
Right. Even in naming his band, he took the name of the band, Fleetwood Mac, takes the drummer's name and part of the bass player's name.
And not his?
To form the name, and not his. His name is Peter Green. The drummer is Mick Fleetwood, right? And the bass player it'll come to me, Mac.
Mac Powell. Okay.
No,
interesting.
Not Mac Powell. That's a different guy.
Mac Powell. He's a Christian artist.
Fleetwood Mac, yeah. McVie. John McVie. So Mac is short for McVie, and they call him Mac.
Okay,
so Fleetwood Mac is named for the drummer and the bass guitar player. Because they're what he called the backbone of Fleetwood Mac. of the band, you know, so they call it Fleetwood Mac. Peter Green was a blues guy, and Bob Welch was a blues guy, and you know, they, so it was blues based. And then, you know, when they came to California and they got the other guys, you know, the Lindsey Buckingham and Stevie Nicks, the band totally changed. So that's a surprise. And I still find today, like when I play Black Magic Woman, like when I'm, you know, when I'm out playing music for people, as I sometimes do, I often find the opportunity to tell people this is not the original version. And they're surprised today. So there may be even people in the Fellow Humans Club here who are surprised to know that, but probably not. We have a very, very educated musical crowd.
Yeah, very musically educated crowd, for sure. The knowledge that I see in the comments blows my mind.
Yeah.
But, you know, quiz me on Star Trek. I'll wow you.
What was the episode called?
Not episode titles. I'm not that kind of nerd. I'll tell you about in-universe stuff. I'm not memorized episode titles nerd.
Okay.
Sorry, there's limits to my memory.
So what do you think of Black Magic Woman? What does it mean lyrically? Do you think he's literally talking about a woman who uses black magic, or do you think
No, I think that this is a love song. Okay. I think he's talking about got a black magic woman. She's got me so blind I can't see. She's trying to make a devil out of me. I think it's just he's found a woman who he's so very much into, he can't see straight. He's willing to do things he didn't think he was capable of, just because he's so very in love with her. My favorite line in the song is definitely, "Don't turn your back on me, baby, because you might just break up my magic stick."
What, do you think there's a euphemism in there somewhere?
I think that's a reference to his little gent's not going to work well if she leaves, because he's going to be so sad and brokenhearted. But I mean, I think it's the typical. We've seen Frank Sinatra with some other songs in this vein. I think "When You Put Your Spell on Me, Baby," I think it's a not generic by any means, but it is a love song. It's a song about how much he's in love with this specific woman and how sad he will be if she leaves him.
Okay, Dave. Well, I have to say, after looking at the information I have on it, "Black Magic Woman" was written by Peter Green in 1968. Inspired by his former girlfriend, Sandra Elsden, whom Green had nicknamed Magic Mama.
Magic Mama. So it was a story written about love.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what it was. So there you go. Musically, what did you think of it?
Musically, it was fun. It was a fun little mildly bluesy tune. I liked when that they let the music breathe. Like, this song was not in a hurry, even though this song was so short. They had no problems taking little breaks, letting the music, letting like the last chord just hang in the air before they felt the need to move on.
And that's the reason I chose this version over the Santana more popular version, because the Santana one is the straight 4/4 beat, clear through beginning to end with no such. And I thought that those little breaks just made it sound a little bit more ominous than the Santana version.
Ominous and also interesting. So I definitely did enjoy the song. I will say that this is a song I would throw directly on that Halloween playlist.
There you go. And what did you think? Now, you and I briefly listened to snippets of the Santana version. What did you think of that one?
Different style. Like, it gives the song an entire different feeling, because it almost sounds like slightly Latino in its sound. It's got like a little bit of bongos, and it has a very different feel. It doesn't have that bluesiness, and it also doesn't have that calm, that willingness to wait while the note is allowed to hang in the air. Like, that is gone from the Santana version of the song.
And now for something completely different.
Here's your question. What Winter Olympic sport sees competitors go down a frozen course head first?
Head first?
Yeah.
I would assume that would be one of the luge events.
I hate to give you the buzzer, Dave. I'm going to let you think about this some more before. Let me. Is that
head first?
Yeah.
Because, like, most of the time they're on a board, they're on skis, they're Winter Olympic.
Mm-hmm.
Head first.
I mean, a frozen course head first.
Most of them, if you fall. That's.
Well, I never thought about it that way, but no, that does not answer the question, dude. Most of them, if you fall.
No, that's all I got, John. Some sort of luge event is all I got.
Dave, it is a Halloween trivia question. Does that help you in any way? Does that little clue help you in any way?
It's just, there's blood. It's scary.
It's called skeleton, Dave, and that is an official Winter Olympic sport, skeleton.
Never heard of it. Never
what?
Heard of it. Nope. Don't know what that
well,
is.
I'm going to have to find me some skeleton video, and in post-production, it's going to be right there.
Professional.
Yeah.
Why does it hurt when I pee?